bodily feelings, the pain and all, and the thoughts. So these are also made up of consciousness. But here there is no form or shape or
no, there, see, the consciousness taken the form of thought. Consciousness takes the form of thought. It's a form.
Thought is a form.
Thought is a form of consciousness.
I don't see, like here I can see one.
No, form means anything which is limited by time and space is called form. Thought appears and disappears.
Not shape.
No, everything is a form. Everything is a form. Thought and the time, it appears and disappears, there's a form. What doesn't appear and disappear is not no form. Space has no form because it doesn't appear and disappear. It's always there in the background.
Space, when sleeping deep sleep, there is no space.
Deep sleep, yeah, it is a manifest reality. But right now, to give example of form, formless space.
Okay.
But space itself is not final. Space appears in my consciousness. I am the final. So, anything else? Any other questions? Any other questions? So, Brahman, the dissection mugitu. So, any questions? What else you want to know?
Last class,
Omkara. So, Omkara has three aspects: Akara, Okara, Makara. I have done a detailed series of lectures are going on in Mandukya Karika, Mandukya Upanishad. You can listen to that. Akara represents your waking state, Okara represents your dream state, Makara represents your deep sleep state. This A-U-Ma, three sounds, Akara, Ukara, Makara, they are sounds generated without using the tongue. A-U-Ma. Every other sound is twisting the tongue. Tongue is pa-ra, tongue is used. Now what is tongue is doing? Tongue is mixing these primary sounds, Akara, Ukara, Makara. So these are basic sounds. So with these basic sounds, all other sounds are created. So like in a television set, three basic colors are there: red, blue, RGB. With that RGB, you are creating millions of colors. So with this three, Akara, Ukara, Makara, you are creating all the sounds. All the sounds become all the names. Ultimately, names are nothing but sounds. So names are nothing but forms in the world. Everything in the world is created by these three alphabets. Names only. Everything is a name. Sun is a name. Moon is a name. Sanskrit, English, Tamil. Everything is a
name.
Made up of Omkara. Akara, Ukara, Makara. Okay. So Akara, Ukara. Name is of what? Name of what? So, no. Om is the sound. So this name is called, this is actually remote. Remote is a name, but name represents an object, right? Name represents. So Omkara is a name. Omkara is everything in the universe is Omkara. So it represents an object. Everything represents object, and objects represent what?
Consciousness.
Existence. Satya, sat. Existence is happens in is existence is consciousness. So every name in the world is name of Brahman only. God's name only. Every form in the world is form of God only. Every name, every form is Brahman only. They are not separate. Whatever you see is Brahman. Whatever you experience is Brahman. Understand? Everything is Brahman. So Omkara, the sound aspect of Omkara represents the manifest reality. The Brahman is manifest is called conditioned consciousness. When you see through the eyes are conditioning the Brahman. When you hear through the sound, hear through ears, the sound is conditioning Brahman. The touch is Brahman, smell is Brahman, everything is Brahman only. Then why did you say not, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect? Why did you say that?
I am not only this body.
I is not the only body, I is everything. And everything is nothing because everything is just a perception. The reality is Brahman, right? We live Brahman, we eat Brahman, experience Brahman all the time. Other than Brahman, it is not there. That's why I told the mantra, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Right? So, from Brahman, the perception rises like a wave and goes back. Is it real? No, because Brahman doesn't change. It's unreal rise, unreal changing is happening, perception is rising. So, it is because feeling, thought, perception. Perception, feeling, perception, thought, feeling. Rise and fall. Right? So that's why Omkara meditation is the highest form of meditation. When you chant Omkara, it rises. Om. It comes back to silence. Rises from consciousness and goes back to consciousness. Silence. The silence represents Brahman, Nirguna Brahma, Para Brahma. The sound represents Saguna Brahma or manifest reality. Manifest reality is Brahman. Are they two different? No. Only perception is different. Right? Understand? Perception is different. Reality is same. You perceive it very differently. That's Brahman. Now, in waking state, I am there, the world is there. I and the world is there. Are they different? You cannot separate out. My seeing, I cannot separate out from you. Sky I am seeing. I cannot see separate sky from my eyes. I cannot separate eyes from my brain. Brain from consciousness. So everything is one reality. In consciousness, perception is rising and falling. Rising and falling. So that you have meant by Om, again go back. So we chant Omkara with a, let the vibrations, first Akara vibration starts in the stomach, Ukara in the heart, Makara in the head. Become aware of the complete experience of Omkara, again silence. Be in the silence, stay there. So that is actually God. See, in Sanatana Dharma, God is a living experience. Another God, you don't have to believe God. In fact, believers of God are not required. The belief in God is all other religions. You believe God because God is here, there and all. Sanatana Dharma, God is living experience for you. Whatever you see, whatever you touch, what you experience is God. Other than God, nothing is there.
Form only. Yeah.
So
is it a thought?
Then this thought is also coming Brahman. Out of this consciousness only. Brahman. Brahman only. Correct.
So that is what continuously this thought is coming that I am this body, I am this
yeah.
body.
That is coming because you told collective consciousness earlier. The collective consciousness is all the consciousness of the world. Everybody is, he is conscious, I am conscious. The collective consciousness is giving the thought that you are a body. It's a part of Maya. I speak to you as Suresh, as a body. So now this quality of consciousness has implanted idea called I am the body for you.
That is result of the collective consciousness. The collective consciousness is there is one consciousness only. No. Collective consciousness means there are four people's consciousness.
The collective consciousness is a perception. One consciousness appears to be
different in
many places because of perception. Perception is not reality. Either I speak of perception or reality. If I speak of reality, there is nothing called collective consciousness, only consciousness is there. If I speak of perception, they say collective consciousness.
So, the single consciousness is divided into by the multiple perceptions. And one of the perception is mind. Mind means this body mind.
I. This you.
So when I come out of this body-mind feeling, go back to the consciousness feeling, so there will be not...
No.
Only that perception is coming out or other perceptions also?
No. When you go to consciousness, no thought. When there is no thought, no world.
So that perception is broken. So that is... But other perceptions...
Everything goes, no? Other perceptions also, if their perception, the thought is...
I mean, like if you are realized, so do you feel that only... this is realization, you are realized and others are not realized?
There's no other.
No, but you don't know multiple perceptions.
That is appearance. Appearance is not the other. Appearance of snake is rope only.
So one rope can be perceived as a snake and also as a necklace or different. So if we know that it is a rope, so other also are.
There's no other. I only up there. I only came from Hyo Chennai. Okay. I only took the oath in the the other day, Prime Minister. Okay, let us do Omkara. So when you chant Omkara, Akara in the stomach, Ukara in the heart, Makara in the head area. So let us do that, Akara, Ukara, Makara, then we will go for Omkara. So become aware of the vibration in the heart, stomach area, heart area, Ukara, Makara. First, stomach. Silence between the two us. Akara represents the waking state, the waking world. Ukara represents the chest, vibration from the chest area. Ukara represents a subtle world or a dream world. It's called Hiranyagarbha or Taijasa. Makara in the head area, in the Adna Chakra. Starts from a deep silence, appears as Makara, disappears as silence again. Now Omkara, be aware of your Sahasrara, top of the head. Om. Stay in the silence. Oh. from sound, silence, deep silence, which is Brahman. Sound arises, it spreads throughout the world. Again, in silence, it goes back to silence.
Thank you.
Asatoma,
Sagamaya,
Tamasoma, Jyotirgamaya, Mrityorma, Amritamgamaya, Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Lokaha Samastaha,
Sukhino
Bhavantu,
Sukhino Bhavantu.
Lokaha Samastaha,
Sukhino
Bhavantu,
Sukhino Bhavantu.
Harihi Om,
Harihi Om.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha,
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Harihi Om,
Harihi Om.